Hello everyone, in this video we get how to semicircle one equilateral triangle and point M, point N. These are given as central semicircles, and point A, point T, these are given as tangent points. Radius of the big semicircle is given 2√3, and the question is, what is the perimeter of the equilateral triangle? First of all, according to two tangent theorem, these two parts must be equal, right? After that, if we connect these two points, here must be equal 90 degrees, right? Because of tangent. And radius of the big semicircle is given 2√3. That means these are must be equal √3. Then, if you focus on this quadrilateral, if you notice that these two sides are equal and these two parts are equal to each other, right? That means ABTM is a kite. Therefore, if we connect its vertices, we get an angle bisector line. So, this blue line is an angle bisector line. That means these angles must be equal to each other, and also these angles must be equal to each other. We know that angle DBC is 60 degrees, right? Because yellow triangle is given as an equilateral triangle. So these angles must be equal 60 degrees. So these are must be equal 30 degrees. After that, if you focus on this triangle, notice that if there's a √3 opposite side of the 60 degrees, opposite side of the 30 degrees here must be equal 1 unit. That means here is also 1 unit. Then, this length, I want to represent with x. So, if we can calculate value of x, we get the perimeter of equilateral triangle, right? Therefore, if we connect these two points, notice that this length is also √3. So, if we focus on this triangle, we get an isosceles triangle. So triangle TMN is an isosceles triangle. Let's call here alpha. That means here is also alpha. We know that sum of the opposite interior angles equals 1 exterior angles, right? So 2 alpha equal 60 degrees, that means alpha equal 30 degrees. Let's write here, alpha equal 30 degrees. So here must be equal 120 degrees. So if you focus on this triangle, if there's a √3 opposite side of the 30 degrees, opposite side of the 120 degrees, must be equal 3 units, right? Let's remind you, if we have an isosceles triangle which base angles equals 30 degrees, like this, let's call these two equal sides as A. So here must be equal A√3. Okay. After that, if you focus on point T, you know that straight angles equals 180 degrees, right? That means 60 degrees left here. Then, if we connect these two points like this, this length is also radius of the big semicircle. So, 2√3. Then, if you focus on triangle NDT, for this triangle, if we apply cosine rule, we get the value of x. Let's clear here. So, for triangle TND, if we apply cosine rule, square of this length, 2 root 3 whole squared, equal 3 squared plus x squared, minus 2 times 3 times x times cosine 60 degrees. So, 12 equal 9 plus x squared minus, you know that cosine 60 degrees equals 1 half, right? So, this again, 3x. Therefore, x squared minus 3x minus 3 equals 0. So, we get a quadratic equation. If we calculate delta equal minus 3 squared minus 4 times 1 times minus 3 equal 21, right? So first root equal minus b minus root delta over 2a, right? So first root equal 3 minus root 21 over 2. Notice that first root is less than 0, but length can't be negative, so we cancel out. Now also, let's calculate second root. Second root equal minus b plus root delta over 2a. So, second root equal 3 plus root 21 over 2. Okay, let's write here x equal 3 plus root 21 over 2. Therefore, if you multiply by 3 one side of the equilateral triangle, we get to its perimeter, right? So, perimeter of the triangle BDC equal 1 plus 3 plus root 21 over 2 times 3, right? So, perimeter equal 5 plus root 21 over 2 times 3. That means the perimeter of the triangle BDC is going to be 15 plus 3 root 21 over 2. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.